So there's so much advice out there and so many things to do if you're starting a new business. But one of the things you do know is you know that your business needs to be on Google. And that's of course where your customers are looking for your business. So they go into their mobiles, they go into their tablets, and they're trying to find locally businesses like yours. And you've heard that Google My Business or Google Business Profile is free. And if you then register your business with it, it gets shown on Google Maps and Google search results. And that's pretty much where you're at this particular moment. But how do you set it up correctly? And if you haven't already set up your Google Business Profile, are there things you can do with your business today that's going to help it in the long run? But you also know that most business owners don't really set up their business correctly on Google. And by knowing what to do, you'll get ahead of the competition and you can get found by your customers. Well, this is a tutorial for you because it's going to handhold you all the way through the process. By the end of the video, you'll know some of the pitfalls that other businesses are falling into. And you'll also find out how you can get a complete course on how to optimize your business to the next level so you can boost it even further. So are you ready for setting up Google My Business and Google Business Profile the right way? Well, let's jump straight in. Well, the first area is business name. Now, it could be you've already got your business name and your business is already up and running. And if that's the case, well, then maybe there's not a lot you can do about this. But if you haven't decided on a business name or you're prepared to change that name, then this is a great opportunity to get ahead on Google. So how does it work? Well, Google's still rewarding keywords within the business name itself. So let's imagine, for example, that you're a plumber and your name is BJ Bryan and you're a plumber in the Miami area. So you've got a few logo ideas here and business name ideas. Do you call yourself BJ Bryan? Do you call yourself Miami Plumber? Well, Miami Plumber is great because it's got the city where you serve. It's also got the industry that you're serving. And those two key names will give you a massive advantage in Google's algorithm at the moment. So how about something like BJ Bryan Miami Plumber? That would work well. That includes your name, but it also includes the area that you serve and the type of business you're serving. And that will certainly get you traction quite quickly in Google search engine results and Google Maps. You'd need to make sure that was on your logo, on your website, make sure it's on signage, maybe the side of your van, on your shop front, really wherever possible, you'd want that to appear in the real world. And that in itself then will give Google the knowledge, particularly with photographs that you take, that that is very much the name of your business. If you've already registered your business and you're not prepared to make those types of changes, well then, that doesn't mean you will be ruled out. Google can still reward you in many other optimizations that we'll look at in a moment. But the point is if you can get your city and your keyword, your main category, within your business name, that will give you a long-term advantage. So the second area you now need to consider, if you've got a business name, is then the domain name. So what's a domain name? Basically, the name of your website. It's where people would type it into www. Or an HTTPS, and then they then put that particular domain name. And ideally, that also has some strength and authority in Google's ranking. And if you can include the name of your business, if you can get it as close as possible to your business name, then that can also prove to be an advantage. So in this case, you may well go for miamiplumber.com or miamiplumber.net or .org or .co.uk if you're in England, for example. Is having a dash between the two okay? Yes, it doesn't really make any difference. It tends to separate the words. But having said that, often people forget to put the dash in and they may end up at Miami Plumber rather than Miami-Plumber. So just be aware of that. What other advantages do you have of having a domain? Well, you can register it with Google. Google Domains is easy enough, and that can then link through to your Google Business Profile if you don't have a website. If you do have a website, then you've got Google Sites or Wix or Shopify, or maybe you've got a WordPress website, then you can have your domain go through to the servers. And what that means is if someone types in your particular domain name, so in this case, miami-plumber.com, then they'll then be taken to your free website with Google Sites or My Business website. To set that up, it's pretty straightforward. You just follow a tutorial. I put the tutorial here if you want to know how to do that for your Google domain. But another major thing you can do with your domain name is you can then have emails at your domain name. So if you're Miami-Plumber, you could be john@miami-plumber.com and lisa@miami-plumber.com. The point is you can have your own emails attached using your own domain. It looks more professional than having a Gmail or a Yahoo or a Hotmail account. People would expect an established business to have the person's name at, and then it would be the domain name of the business. The third area is description. Why is a description so important? Well, your description really should be consistent. You should know what it is about your business that's unique. You should know why people should choose you rather than your competitor. And your description is used in so many other areas on the web. So you want it on your about page, you want it on your description of your Google business profile, you want it on Facebook, you want it on Bing, wherever you register, Apple Maps, you want the same consistent description. Why? Because Google will take this and will give it authority if it understands what it is that you do. If you don't understand what it is that you do, how will Google ever point the right customers to you? So you've probably heard of the elevator pitch. So what is the elevator pitch? Well, an elevator pitch is a basic description or a persuasive speech as to what would give your organization something that's above others. And it only needs to be about 20 to 30 seconds. And that's why the name elevator pitch has been given it. Because the idea is if you're in an elevator, by the time you've explained what it is you do, what your business does so well, it would only take 20 to 30 seconds. And the other person would get an idea of that as they then get out the elevator. So if you haven't done so already, just write out a couple of lines that take 20 or 30 seconds, memorize them, and then you're ready to go with your description on Google Business Profile. Now, the fourth area is called NAP. Stands for name, address, phone number. But you can add to that email, website, and a few other things as well. Why do people talk about NAP? But what it really is referring to is a consistency. So like with that description, you want it consistent out there on the website. At the same time, you also want your name, the business name, the address of where your business is, and the phone number that you're using for your business to be consistent. Because Google doesn't always recognize it when it goes out and searches the web. If it finds the name of your business, 1 minute it's a limited company, the next minute it's not. Next time you spell it slightly differently, if it gets inconsistency, it will see these as separate businesses. Now, Google is quite intelligent. It can work it out for itself on occasions, but don't put it down to chance. Make sure that you've got consistency wherever possible. So here's my bit of advice. Have your business name, have your address, your phone number, your description, your elevator pitch. Have it all written out on a Word document. And when you start registering your business citation sites, indexes, copy and paste the information so that it's consistently the same. Now, do you know what the most important algorithm ranking factor is in Google Business Profile in 2022? Well, it's the fifth thing we mentioned here. It's the category, particularly the primary category. So when you choose the category that's most suitable for your business, that's when Google then puts you up against a competition. Now you can have secondary categories and they should be supportive of the business you do. So it's not about just getting involved in as many categories as possible, but it's about choosing the right primary category. How do you choose a primary category though, if there are two or three categories that are suitable for your business? I did a study on this, so it was regarding key cutter. They also sometimes in England, they serve as shoe shops as well. So they are cobblers, they mend shoes, but they also cut keys. Two very different types of skill sets that are often in the same shop. So what do you choose? Are you a shoe shop? Are you a key cutter? And often they even have trophies. So then are you a trophy inscriptor? There's several categories you could choose here. How do you know which one to choose? Well, I put together a video that's going to help you do that. So head over to this video after you've watched this one and you'll see how to choose if that's the case of your category. Well, the next area you need to consider is one that's full of pitfalls. And this is where a lot of people get banned by Google, is understanding, are you a service? Are you a shop? Or are you hybrid? And once you understand what you are, then as long as you get it right in Google's eyes too, you'll be fine. So a shop is in effect a place where people can come and visit you. So whether it's on a high street, whether you have an office, then you're considered a shop. And that will give you a pin on the map because people can get directions to go directly to you to visit you. Whereas a service is where you go out to people, but they have no way of knowing where you are. So you have an area that you serve instead. Again, people get confused here. They think then that they're missing out on the algorithm because they don't actually have a pinpoint on a map. And to some degree, that's true, but Google's trying to now get around that by making it more of an even field. And for a hybrid, it's a bit of both. So maybe you go out and serve customers, but at the same time, you also allow them to come to you. So you need to be clear, which one of those three are you when you're registering your Google Business Profile? So at this point, you might now be ready to register your business on Google. And it's so easy to do. Do it the correct way. Within 5 minutes, you could already be getting customers ringing up your business. it can have that immediate effect. So if you want to know how to do that, then I've got a video here that will show you how to do that within 5 minutes. But if you've already set up your business, you've already registered it with Google, and that's the point you're at now, then you'll need to have a strategy going forward to then beat the competition. You'll need a strategy to get you into the top of Google Business Profile. And most people fail this hurdle because they register it and they leave it. They have no strategy. So you'll be glad to know I put together a video here that will show you 3 different strategies you can use that will then amplify your business so that it gets found in Google search results. So head over to there now and I'll see you on that video.